Hello and welcome back. This time we're talking about way measurement, position measurement, length measurement. I write position measurement, okay? Position measurement. Position measurement. Position measurement. Basically we can distinguish between two things in position measurement. To explain it, I will use already an optical system. Okay, I will explain also an optical position measurement system. So there are absolute position measurement. And there's incremental. Incremental position measurement. Okay, I will now try to explain what this is. Yeah, therefore, I am going to draw already the first position measurement thing. Yeah, I will try at least. Yeah? One possible position measurement is the optical position measurement. Yeah, and the absolute optical position measurement looks somewhat like this. There is a ruler. Okay. This ruler does have some lines on it. Okay. And this ruler has sections. These are usually glass rulers, very transparent, very nice, very shiny. Also sensitive, but they are usually built in very, very rigid, so nothing can happen. Okay, so this might be a ruler. Let's say here's the end of the ruler. Okay. Then some of these squares, they are etched, yeah, with some acid. At least some are transparent and some are etched, and they will look like, for instance, like this. Everything I'm marking now is an etched one. Okay, there's an etched one. I'm not sure if you recognize this, what I'm drawing here. But this is some sort of code. This is some sort of code. There's a separate video about this. What I try to draw here is the so-called gray code. Okay. There was a video about this. And I think it should be obvious. Or obvious, maybe not obvious, but I think it should be clear what I try to show here. So some of these are etched by acid, and some of these are not. Okay. Every combination, okay, maybe for better understanding, there are, let's say we are at this position, there are here detectors. Okay. And on the other side, there are senders, yeah, light sources. For every line, one light source, okay? And for every line, one detector. And they will shine through a certain column of this. And this gives a pattern. So this gives a pattern. Meaning, if this is shiny or transparent, we would see here 1, 1, 0, 1. And this code shows or gives the position on the ruler. Okay. If I do have more positions, then I do have more lines of the ruler. Okay. There are simply more lines of the ruler. the longer I need to measure, yeah, the longer the lines are. Okay. The thing what I drawn here is the so-called gray code. It's often used in such position measurement systems because gray code has the advantage that only one bit is changing. So if this is not aligned correctly and we are slightly reading wrong, then I'm off one bit. This is not too much. If this would be, for instance, binary code, yeah, then I can be off far, far away. Okay. Absolute position measurement system. These lines are usually somewhere at a micrometer, a thousandth part of a millimeter, so a micrometer size. They are etched very precise. Okay, they are code lines organized in column. Every column is at a certain position. If I turn the thing on, it reads the position and knows exactly where it is. In absolute matters, yeah, knows absolutely where it is. Yeah. In example, I don't know, 10.23 millimeters at the scale. Yeah. This is given by this code, reading code. Absolute measurement. Yeah. That's an absolute measurement, and it's the optical variant of this. Incremental measurement does work a little bit different. Yeah, what I maybe forgot to mention, this ruler is moving. Yeah, this ruler is moving, the light sources and the detectors stand still. So if the ruler is moving, then we know how far or at which position it has moved. Okay. Incremental thing looks a little different. Yeah, not too much. There is also some sort of ruler. Yeah. But inside this ruler, there are only tiny little gaps.
They should be in regular distance. Yeah? They are in regular distance. Like my drawing here, they look a little bit unordered, but in reality, they are in regular distance. Okay.
This time, I only need one light source. Yeah? This time, I only need one light source. This is shining through, and I only need one detector. There's this one detector. Okay. Whenever this ruler is moving, yeah, this detector gets dark bright. Okay. This means if I count now, it's connected to a counter. If I count now, how many dark brights things I've observed, yeah, I know exactly how far this was moved. Okay. So I did not know where I started, yeah, but I know exactly how far it moved. This is incremental. Yeah. From a starting point, I increment the counter. Okay. This knows how far it has moved. Yeah. In example, 27.36 millimeters. Millimeters. Huh? There's only one issue with this thing here. It doesn't move. It doesn't know if it moved in this direction or in this direction. Okay. There might be an issue, so I need a second receiver, yeah, and this second receiver, if we are looking
on our ruler from above, and there are the gaps, there are the gaps, and in between, there are no gaps, yeah,
I need to place, and there is the light coming, light, it's parallel, let's say, yeah, I need to place one receiver exactly at the position, at this position, yeah, and the other receiver must be exactly at the border, yeah. What does it mean now? What does this mean? If it's moving in one direction, if it's moving in one direction, I will get, I will make this one, receiver one, yeah. This will get, will be high, and then will get low, yeah. Will get high again, somewhat later if it's moving, yeah. And I will say this is number two. This is now high, will then get low, and will then get high. So I do have a shift between those two. I do have a shift between those two. Yeah. So the only thing I need to know, I need to have a look at, if this is changing, have a look at here. If this is low, yeah, then I know it's moving one direction, because, you know, if I come from this direction, this one will go low, and afterwards this will go low. This will go high, and afterwards this will go high. So this is the first one. Yeah? If I'm going in this direction, this will get low, and this is low, then this get low. This is high, and this get high. So this is the first one, yeah? Which is changing. And depending on which is the first one which is changing, I can distinguish if I'm moving left or right. Okay? And then I know not only 26.36 millimeters in this example, but I also know, for instance, left. Okay? Incremental position measurement. Easier, yeah? Easier, more complicated. This one needs exactly where it is. Yeah? This one, we must zero it. Yeah? We must drive to a defined position at the beginning, yeah. If it wakes up, the system wakes up, yeah, it, this one doesn't know where it is. This one does exactly, yeah. More expensive, less expensive, yeah. Here I do have the risk, if I'm losing some steps, yeah, then I might get accumulation of the error, yeah. If I'm losing one step, okay, then I'm a micrometer wrong, yeah, but I'm losing more than one step, yeah, then this will accumulate, this error will accumulate. This cannot happen here, okay? So these are the two possibilities in position measurement. Absolute position measurement, incremental position measurement, yeah? And incremental, we have to have a second, if we want to distinguish the direction, we have to have a second probe. And these two things I mentioned is the optical variant of this. This incremental one we already used before in Arduino, yeah, our rotary encoder. There's a video about this, you can watch it. We are exactly looking at this one. Yeah. It's not optical, it's electrical, but it's an incremental thing. Yeah. Video, you can watch it. Yeah. That's our first video about position measurement. Next video about position measurement will be also a thing we know from our Arduino course, potentiometer. We will use a potentiometer. Okay. For this time, thank you very much for listening, and goodbye.